India is not a stranger to rural distress, but the amount of farmer mobilizations, anger and agony that we've seen over the past 4 years, and the number of times the farmers have A, trotted themselves out or been available for mobilization by a series of organizations is quite noteworthy. So if that sentiment catches on, ki this is a sarkar, this is a kisan virodhi party, it's a soot boot ki sarkar, that doesn't augur well for any party wanting to rule India. What we see overtly television media, but even other than that, the social media, WhatsApp groups, we heard of immense number of groups in Karnataka which forced WhatsApp and Facebook to change their policies also about forwarding abilities, a near dominance by the BJP of the narrative, which centered around identity issues, which centered around Narendra Modi's policies, whether it's the Jan Dhan Yojana, the success of demonetization, and of with a very strong kind of underpinning of identity, anger, which came out very clearly in the Ram Mandir mobilization that happened with the campaign, that seems to have been hit badly. Because the entire spin given to demon was a kind of almost a response to the characterization of BJP as a soot boot ki sarkar, which the BJP was very anxious to live down after losing Bihar. So that again, they are again in a kind of a Bihar situation, and in a sense worse than Bihar because it extends geographically over a very large area and at the heart of India. He carried each and every controversial kind of issue loudly and clearly and spelt it out literally through large number of campaigns. He spoke of Nirav Modi, he spoke of Ambanis, Adanis, but they tried to rally this whole idea that, you know, we are not pro-rich or the rich are out to get you and this is a party of the Bada Saabs or the NPAs or the big money, etc., etc. So I think that once that catches on, and it's almost seen, there was a huge risk that Rahul Gandhi was running, that all these issues, whether it's corruption, Choksi, Modi, Rafael, would be discredited if he loses a public support on these, because it would be easy for the BJP to say, ah, you know, let's talk about Augusta Westland alone. But that gets a big fillip now with him getting the mandate in these states, having campaigned on these issues. And of course, the way he is said to have managed his local leadership and brought these various satraps together, and is in a sense almost, in Madhya Pradesh for example, made it not a case of too many cooks spoiling the broth, but allowed cooks to get their own like sort of material and cook up a decent stew. Rajasthan also has been a case in point where there were two very prominent people said to be close to the Congress president, Ashok Gehlot, who's the organization secretary, and Sachin Pilot, who's worked very closely with him in with Rahul Gandhi in the Lok Sabha, who were the two very obvious contenders for the chief minister's post. But in the way he kept everybody guessing and used their utilities, their social class utilities, one being a backward, a Mali, Sachin Pilot being a Gujar, being sort of this more urban person, getting his way with the media, etc., but was able to kind of bring it all together. That was, you know, another case of him turning something seen as a disadvantage into a bit of a strength and making it work for the Congress.